Hello kids, we welcome you to our Sunday School Virtual Online. I'm glad that you joined us today and we're gonna have a lot of fun today and a lot of learning also. Alright, so now it's time to sing and dance. Anybody out there ready and excited to sing and dance? I know you are. So just go ahead and make yourself that you're free and loosen yourself up. Get ready, be excited, be happy. We got some singing and dancing coming your way!
I'm gonna run, run, run to His love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the one I trust. When I'm alone, when I'm afraid, I know that He is with me every day. He's by my side, He hears me when I pray. Jesus, I trust in Him. I'm gonna run, run, run to His love, love, love. I'm gonna sing, sing, sing to God's Son. I'm gonna shout, shout, shout the name of Jesus. He is the when I'm away.
Wasn't that an amazing time? I just loved singing and dancing to that. I know, I felt like a kid, so am I part of the New City Kids too? Maybe I am. All right, so now it's time for story. I know you're excited about that. So sit down, pay attention, focus, and learn from the story time.
Hey kids, welcome back. I hope you guys are all doing well, and I have a super interesting story this week. And this week's story is called Overcoming the Fear Caused by Sin. Are you guys ready? I am super excited to tell you this story, and I'm sure you guys are excited too. So let's get into the story. We all know that when Jesus lived on this earth, he went around teaching people, right? So it was another day and Jesus was teaching the people when suddenly the Pharisees got a woman who was caught sinning, and they told Jesus, we caught this woman sinning, and according to the law of Moses, she needs to be stoned to death. And now that woman stood there with so much of guilt, with so much of shame, and she was terrified. She was so afraid that her life was at risk. Now Jesus, knowing that these people were setting a trap for him, he knelt down on the ground. He bent towards the ground and then he started writing on the sand. Jesus knew that if he said, stone her to death, then he was going against the Roman law, which did not allow the Jews to execute their own criminal, and also that the people around will stop trusting Jesus. And if he said, do not stone her to death, then he was going against the law of Moses. The people around started to insist and persist, and they were saying, Jesus, tell us what to do. Jesus, tell us what to do. Jesus lifted his head up and he looked at the people there and he said, if there is anyone in this crowd that is without sin, let him be the first person to stone her to death. And he came back, looked down on the ground, and he continued to write on the ground. Do you know what happened, kids? One by one, from the young to the old, everybody put their stones down and they started to leave. After everyone left, Jesus looked up at the woman and he asked, where are these people? Didn't they condemn you? Didn't they punish you? The woman said, no, they did not condemn me. And Jesus said, go, because I also will not condemn you. Go and live your life without sin. Yes, little kids, Jesus was the only person in that crowd who lived a sinless life, and even he chose not to punish her because he loved us so much. He loved people so much. Kids, do you know what the learning from this story is? Sin causes us to fear, but the love of God sets us free from it all. One more time, sin causes us to fear, but the love of God sets us free from it all. And this week's memory verse is, for God did not give us the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and sound mind. One more time, for God did not give us the spirit of fear, but of power, love, and sound mind. The reference is 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. Bye!
Thank you, Teacher Agnes, for teaching us such a wonderful story. I hope you kids learned something, and I hope you took something down. But right now, something more interesting. Go ahead and grab all your craft items and get ready, because we have some craft time.
Thank you. Hello kids, let us pray. Close your eyes and repeat after me. Our precious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the grace and mercy upon us. We thank you for the Sunday school, Bible stories and songs we learned today. Help us to grow more in your ways and in your wisdom. Bless us, our family and our friends. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen.
Wow, today's Sunday school was amazing. I hope you kids learned. I hope you kids enjoyed and had fun. Until next time, bye.